Boca Raton, what is happening? This is your local real estate market update as of July 1st, 2024. And the big news, we're seeing the biggest drop in home sales in the last 5 years. Yep, right here in South Florida. I'm Larry Mastropieri, broker owner of the Mastropieri Group. Let's get into it. The average home in Boca Raton going under contract went from 58 days, which isn't a lot, to 74 days, which still isn't a lot, but that's still a 28% increase in days on market. And since 2022, we've seen the days on market increase slowly, but now the trend seems to be increasing a little bit more dramatically as we're entering the summer months of 2024. You might expect, since it now takes longer to sell a home, that prices would come down a bit. But let's look at the average sale price data from June of 2023 and compare it to June of 2024. You can see we've experienced a crazy 17% increase in the average sale price. What is happening? So according to this statistic, homes are now worth 17% more than the same time last year. This created a ton of questions when I was doing this analysis. Why is this happening when it's taking longer to sell a home? And the reality is the average sale price went from 1.029 million here in Boca to 1.2 million year over year. You can see the average sale price has been steadily climbing with a little noise over the past 12 months, especially February through June. But wait, before we jump to any conclusions here, we should always cross-check the average data with the median data to make sure random large deals don't skew our analysis in any one month we're comparing. So if we look at the median sales price data from June of 2024 and compare it to June of 2023, you can see in Boca, we've experienced a whopping 21% increase in the median sales price. This blows my mind. What this is in fact saying is a house bought last year for $580,000 now today would cost $700,000. This is so interesting. Housing prices continue to rise while sales are slowing down, but there is much more to unpack in this story, so stay tuned. The sale to original list price ratio shows that a lot more homes are selling for less than their original asking price. In the crazy days, March, April, May of 2022, most properties were selling for the asking price or even higher. But now properties are selling for about 10% less than their original asking price on average. This stat has been slowly coming down over the past 12 months, which is slightly concerning because typically, pre-2019, homes would sell for about 92-93% of their original asking price. And now homes are selling for about 90% of the original asking price. This is signaling more downward pressure on the market and is likely due to the increase in inventory and slightly less demand. And moving on, the number of listings graph also has a story to tell us. This data helps us understand the current and anticipated inventory in the Boca Raton real estate market. And as we all know, prices in real estate are a function of supply and demand. So let's discuss the supply. In June of 2024, our real estate market closed 392 homes, and we added 677 new active listings. That's 20% less homes sold than the same time last year. That is a big number. And if we're watching the trend line, what are we seeing? We're seeing active listings going up, inventory going up. And in fact, the amount of listings going under contract has come down a little bit, which is slightly concerning because it's suggesting demand might be diminishing. And guess what? This is all happening during the selling season here in South Florida. More inventory is being added to the market than we can put under contract or close in any one month. And guess what? This isn't a new trend. This has been happening over the past 12 months or so. And to support the comments I just made, as of July 1st, 2024, we're seeing a 39% increase in inventory compared to the same time last year. That means we now have over one-third more inventory and less homes are being sold. And this is interesting too. 9% less homes went under contract in June of 2024 when you compare it to June of 2023. You would think that more inventory mixed with a lower quantity of sales would what? Drive prices down. But really, we should look at the historical averages of inventory before we jump to any conclusions. And when we do that, we see that inventory today is still 14% less than December of 2019. So I think the takeaway here is that inventory is obviously consistently increasing, but we have some room for more inventory before prices start to come down. So here's my take on all this from the field. In the last 12 months, I've sold about 110 or more homes. And I would say just being out there, it doesn't feel like prices are going up as much as the sold price data suggests. In fact, it feels a little soft. It doesn't really feel like a seller's market, nor does it really feel like a buyer's market. Homes are sitting on the market longer, and in some cases, buyers are able to negotiate considerably more than just a few months ago. And as I like to do, let's add another stat to support the comments I just made. This is another key data point that I always look at. It's the absorption rate. It's a good way to gauge whether it's a seller's market or a buyer's market. So what's absorption rate? Let me explain it to you in layman's terms real quick. If no new properties were added to the market and sales continued at a steady pace, it shows how long the current inventory of properties that are on the market today would last at the current rate of sales. I love this because it takes into account supply and demand. The absorption rate trend here in Boca Raton has been changing for sure. The absorption rate is now 5.7 months, which is higher than it was about a year ago at 4.06 months. Typically, a 6-month absorption rate is considered a neutral market. Anything above that is considered a buyer's market. Obviously, anything below that is considered a seller's market, which is where we've lived more recently. So you can see with the absorption rate close to 6 months, we're transitioning from a seller's market to a neutral slash buyer's market. It's important to know that pre-2019, historically, the absorption rate has been in the fives. So we're right around historical averages right now. All right, that's all the data I have for you today. Thank you so much for sticking it out with me. Real quick, I'll share my final thoughts and interpretation of the data. First, the ongoing price growth really continues to surprise me, especially since there's other indicators in this market that are suggesting prices should be softening significantly and or coming down. I do still believe prices will continue to come down and or soften. I'm not saying prices will fall, but the rate of growth will likely slow much more in the coming months. And furthermore, from my experience in the field, homes that are in top condition in great locations will continue to be in high demand. You know, the ones that check all the boxes for the buyers. In contrast, properties that really don't measure up will become even harder to sell. And this is very typical in a market with increasing inventory and or waning demand. Right now, today, if you're a buyer, you'll have more negotiating power in a transaction and you'll see better and better buying opportunities coming, most likely. If you're a seller, on the other hand, this is also a good time to sell, as I'd be very surprised if the increase in prices continue at this pace. Overall, I think where we're trending is a healthier market for Florida as a whole and specifically Boca Raton. And thank you guys again for tuning in. We know the market here in Boca Raton because we sell more homes than anyone else. So if you have any questions about the market, please don't hesitate to reach out. I'm Larry Mastropieri, broker owner of the Mastropieri Group, based right here in Boca. We'll see you guys on the next video.